In this breaking story, Donald Trump has threatened retribution again against some high-ranking Democrats, and one of them responded with one part return volley and one part confusion to what Trump is talking about. And I'll break down the full story for you next, including how Trump is setting up his henchmen to do the retribution dirty work. For context, the politician that Trump wants revenge on in this story is Adam Schiff. He is now a senator, but while in the House, he served on the committee that investigated the January 6th Capitol assault and Trump's role in it. Have a look at this video that shows exactly how Trump feels about Schiff, and then I'll detail Trump's nefarious plan against him and other committee members, and then play the breaking story that is Schiff's reaction to Donald Trump's latest ramblings of revenge.
And we deal with real scum. I mean, like a guy like Adam Shifty Schiff. He's a sleazebag. And he's probably going to be a senator, if you can believe it. But I call him Watermelon Head. He has the... No, he's unattractive, both inside and out. That is... No, but this is a really bad guy. This is a dishonest guy. Not a dumb guy at all. He's got the smallest neck I've ever seen on a human being. He will never be a football player, I can tell you. But he's a smart guy, but he's just a sleazebag.
Now let's get into the nuts and bolts of today's story via this MSNBC conversation, and then I'll have the report about Trump's henchmen who will carry out the revenge and Schiff's reaction.
During an interview on NBC's Meet the Press yesterday, the president-elect also said members of the House January 6th Select Committee ought to go to jail.
And everybody on that committee, for what they did, honestly, they should go to jail.
That's obviously a red siren. And I would say specifically for Joe Biden when he's talking about what pardons need to be issued. But for everybody post-election that said, oh, well, you know, people didn't want the fascist rhetoric. They didn't want the harsh retribution. They were voting because of the price of bread and gasoline. Well, Donald Trump post-election still talking this way.
The idea that members of Congress who are doing their job, doing their investigation, came up with their conclusions and then reported those should go to jail. Obviously, we've never heard any other president in history say that that would be the case.
There's a very clear call for members of the January 6th committee to go to jail. These were members of a congressional committee that followed House rules, created that committee, issued subpoenas, interviewed people in private, interviewed them in public. I am, you know, not a lawyer, but as I've talked to people who worked on the January 6th committee and other people who've come up, they say they've done nothing wrong. And then we can talk more about the second part of the of that clip where he suddenly says, but I'm not going to order anyone to do anything. It's up to Kash Patel, his choice for FBI director, and Pam Bondi, his choice for AG. And that fits an old pattern of Trump kind of putting the really hard stuff on other people and trying to keep his fingerprints off of anything that would be sort of blatantly improper.
So what is Adam Schiff's reaction to all of this? He says the message that Trump is signaling is more dangerous to the system than it is to him. And he says that he's confused by one of the themes within Trump's reoccurring threat. Have a listen.
Senator-elect Schiff served on the House Select Committee to investigate the January 6th attack on the United States Capitol. And, sir, I'd love your thoughts on being sworn in today amidst a cloud of what President-elect Trump said.
In terms of the president's threats, I would say a couple things. First, all of us that worked on the January 6th committee are proud of the work that we did. We exposed one of the darkest chapters of our history when a president incited a violent attack on the Capitol to try to stop the peaceful transfer of power. The vast majority of our witnesses were Republicans. Some of them were high-ranking Republicans in the Trump administration who testified under oath and in public hearings so that the country could hear and see and learn about what took place on that awful day. A really important form of congressional accountability. So we're proud of what we did. But I do think to underscore the point you were all just making, this is not just about retribution against those of us on the committee. This is about sending a message that no one better hold him to account in his second term. No one better look at what he does, do their congressional job, that he is intent on trying to break down these checks and balances in our system, that's where the danger lies, more so than to the members of the committee. I think the American people are very concerned about crime. They wanted an FBI director and an attorney general to deal with fentanyl and deal in California with smash and grab robberies. This is not what they're looking for, to turn the agencies into some vehicle of political retribution.
One of the things that he accused the committee of is illegally destroying records, among other things, along with saying that y'all should go to jail. What's your response?
You know, I've seen him make that allegation before, and candidly, I don't know what the heck he's talking about.
What I found most interesting in this story was the mention of pardons. Joe Biden definitely has to take some heat for going back on his word about Hunter, but there is some room for understanding in that situation because Biden said what he said then, not realizing that one day an extreme Donald Trump would return to office and attempt to appoint extremists in the roles of attorney general and FBI director, while at the same time priming them with extreme directives. And that is the danger to the system that Adam Schiff speaks of. Our Constitution grants the president broad powers to issue pardons, including the preemptive ones that we're likely to see in the weeks to come. And it's very unfortunate to see them politicized this way, but by issuing them to potential targets of Trump's revenge agenda and his henchmen, Biden can protect the individuals who have been serving the values of our democracy.